Hey now, Rodney R. Dixon here with the unboxing of the Sirius XM Snap. Here is the front box. It reads, Sirius XM Snap in-vehicle radio. Experience the best in audio entertainment. And here it lists the channels, very important. Large Howard Stern logo, Howard 100, Howard 101, very important. And as well, I'll mention all of them, what the heck. Classic vinyl. The 20 on 20, Raw Dog Comedy, BPM, Prime Country, CNN, Real Jazz, Cosmo Radio, ESPN Radio, 8 on 8, Radio Disney, Martha Stewart Living Radio, Elvis Radio, Hip Hop Nation, Sirius XM Hits 1, Siriously Sinatra, the NBA, Alt Nation, NHL Home Ice, Oprah Radio, Hair Nation, Symphony Hall, and NFL. Okay, the side reads, everything you need to enjoy Sirius XM in your car. Works on the XM network. XM subscription required. I wonder about that. Works on the XM network. Because even though Sirius and XM merged, my understanding was the bands were still separate. So for example, since this works on the XM network, technically, I shouldn't be getting Howard 100 and Howard 101. We'll have to see how that works out. Sirius XM, hear what you've been missing. Over 120 channels of music, talk, and sports. Commercial-free music from every genre. The biggest names in talk, news, and comedy. Live sports and expert opinion. Digital sound quality, coast to coast. NASCAR Radio, DePulse, Blue Collar Radio, Deep Tracks, Ozzy's Boneyard, The Joint, Outlaw Country, Classic Rewind, 90s on 9, Kids Place Live, CFL. On the other side, in French, and they show Octane, Coffee House, Shade 45, Liquid Metal, Spa, Soul Town, Caliente, The Faction, Lithium, Willie's Roadhouse, and Met Opera Radio. The top reads, once again, experience the best in audio entertainment. Bottom, that might be important, I won't show that. Distributed by Ericsson Consumer. Okay. Back reads, Snap, in-vehicle radio, features, easy to read display, view artist, song title, and channel information, 5-channel presets, fast access to your favorite channels, fully adjustable, flexible mount allows for convenient placement in your vehicle. A Snap to install, a Snap to use. And there is the module with the connector and the, what's that called? The lighter socket adapter. Here's the version in French. The Snap is the easiest and most affordable way to get Sirius XM in your vehicle. Whether you're in your car, truck, boat, or RV, this radio is a Snap to install and a Snap to use. Let's get on with the unboxing. Got my trusty box cutter here. Gonna cut the two tabs open. Gotta be careful. Come on. It's a little tricky. Oh, that's why. Turns out it was affixed to the side of the box as well. It's no good. Ooh, geez. This box is very flimsy, very easy to rip. I already ripped it twice now. Anyway. Opening it up, got some flap action. Close the blade, yeah, it's closed, good. Okay, there's a slide out compartment here. Let's see what's doing. That's all in the box, looks like. I'll put this aside. You didn't hear it fall. Okay, Sirius XM quick start guide, Snap in-vehicle radio. Install the magnetic mount antenna. Mount the magnetic mount antenna on the outside of your vehicle, on the horizontal surface. Jeez, that doesn't sound very secure. That will always face the sky. The antenna contains a strong magnet that will stick to any metal part of your vehicle, but will not damage the vehicle. For most vehicles, the best location is on the roof above the front windshield, as close to being centered between the left and right sides as the cable length will allow. For convertible vehicles that do not have room above the windshield, place the antenna on the hood of the vehicle at the corner nearest the windshield. Consult a professional installer if your vehicle roof or hood is non-metallic, i.e. fiberglass, or you have difficulty finding a location for your antenna. So sedans and coupes, right there. Pickups and SUV, same place. Convertibles. If the antenna cannot be placed above the windshield, place it on the vehicle hood. Tip. Mounting the magnetic mount antenna. When mounting the magnetic mount antenna, be sure that the area is clean and dry before using the alcohol prep pad. Avoid locating the antenna near other antennas, i.e. GPS, cellular, AM, FM, as well as roof rack or other items that can obstruct the view to the satellites. If you're installing the antenna at the roof edge or hood edge, install the cable routing adapter to direct the antenna cable downward. So, cable routing adapter orientation. Oh, I see. To make sure it goes downward. I gotcha. Place the antenna wire into the groove of the cable routing adapter. Slide the cable routing adapter down the antenna wire and press it into the antenna until it is flush with the bottom of the antenna. Okay. When routing the antenna cable, press the antenna wire under the rubber molding around... under the rubber molding. I hate that. Around the front windshield to the nearest corner. Then route the cable out of the windshield molding into the rubber weather stripping around the door opening. Lift the weather stripping from the opening and tuck the cable inside it. Then replace the weather stripping. Run the cable inside of the weather stripping to the bottom of the door opening. Hide the antenna wire inside the cabin. Pull the cable out of the weather stripping at the bottom of the door opening and route it under the carpet towards the cigarette lighter power adapter socket. Coil any excess cable in a hidden location, such as under the carpet, keeping it away from any vehicle pedals or control. Secure the excess cable with wire ties. Tip, always be careful to include enough slack in your routing to accommodate open doors or the hood lid. Use electrical tape to secure the cable in areas so that hinges do not pinch the cable with the door. Plug the magnetic mount antenna connector to the antenna connector on the snap base. The antenna plug and cable will fit into the recess on top of the snap base. Antenna plug, antenna connector, okay, very good. To find a location for the snap, the snap mounts into your vehicle's cigarette lighter or power adapter socket. If your vehicle has more than one, be sure to choose the one that doesn't interfere with the driver's vision or access to driving controls. The one which won't interfere with the deployment of airbags, oh geez, or other safety equipment, and make the snap easily accessible for operation. Note, after plugging the snap into the cigarette lighter socket and connecting the cables, remember to route the cables so they do not interfere with safe operation of the vehicle. There we go, cigarette lighter or power adapter socket. 3. Activate snap with my saliva. So sorry. Before proceeding with connecting the audio, the courtesy period included with your snap needs to be activated. Be sure your vehicle is outside and the antenna has a clear view of the sky. Power your snap by pressing the power button. When the snap powers on, after the welcome to XM message, you will be prompted to press 123 to begin. Press the number button 1, then 2, then 3. If the magnetic mount antenna has been installed correctly and snap is receiving the XM signal, a courtesy period begun message will verify that the courtesy period has begun. You will then be notified about the length of the courtesy period and prompted to set up an audio connection. Snap will tune to channel 247. Although at this point you have access to all the channels, leave it tuned to channel 247 until you have set up the audio connection. If acquiring signal, check antenna connection, or no signal, check antenna is displayed instead of the trial period has begun message. This indicates that you are not receiving the XM signal. Be sure the vehicle is outside and the antenna has a clear view of the sky. Verify that you have installed and connected the antenna as described. Also refer to mount the magnetic mount area on page 14 of the user guide. Refer to troubleshooting on page 36 of the user guide for additional help. 4. Connect the audio. To play audio through your vehicle stereo or FM radio, decide on one of the following audio connection options. Option 1. Best. Use the provided aux-in cable if your vehicle stereo system has an auxiliary input connection. Plug one end of the cable into the audio connector on the Snap and the other end into the auxiliary input connection on the vehicle stereo system. Refer to your vehicle's owner manual to find the location of the auxiliary input jack or consult the vehicle dealer. Turn on your vehicle's stereo system and set it to play input from the auxiliary input source or cassette mode if using a cassette adapter. You should now hear XM audio. The installation is complete. Proceed to step 5 to subscribe. So, aux in, there you go, aux in cable, audio connector, optional cassette adapter. Audio quality. They say that best is FM direct antenna. The auxiliary cable is also best. Cassette adapter is better. Power connect is good. Tip, the auxiliary input jack may be located on the faceplate of the vehicle radio, on the back of the radio, anywhere on the front dash panel, inside the glove compartment, or inside the center console, in between the front seats. Option 2, good. Use the power connect feature of the Snap. Power connect plays the audio through your vehicle's FM radio. You'll first need to find an available FM channel. An available FM channel is one that is not being used by an FM radio station in your area. When you tune your FM radio to an available channel, you should only hear static or silence, not talk or music. Really? We recommend the following method to find an available FM channel. Manually tune through your local FM channels on your vehicle's FM radio. Locate and create a list of channels that aren't being used by any FM radio station. Write down the list. Once you have created your list of available FM channels, you'll need to find one that best provides the best match for Snap. Tip, you'll need to use the manual tune function of your vehicle's FM radio to tune through every FM channel one by one. Turn on your vehicle's FM radio, start at 88.1, and use the manual tune function on your vehicle's FM radio to tune through each FM channel one by one, 88.1 followed by 88.3, etc., to locate channels that aren't being used by a local FM radio station. Write down each FM channel that has only static or silence on it until you reach 107.9. Jeez, that's a lot of tuning. Pick the first FM channel on your list from step 1. Turn on your vehicle's FM radio if you have not already done so, and tune it to the FM channel. Match FM channels, 90.1, 90.1. Set your Snap to transmit on the same FM channel that you have selected in step 1. Press the FM button on the top of the Snap. Okay, on the top of the Snap there's an FM button. Rotate the control knob to select the available FM channel you choose in step 1. You should hear the XM channel 247 through your vehicle's FM radio. If you are satisfied with sound quality, installation is complete. A comma would have helped. If you are not, move to the next FM channel on your list and tune your vehicle's FM radio and Snap to this new FM channel. Continue until you have found an FM channel with which you are satisfied. Once you have found a satisfactory FM channel to use, press and hold 1 until the 1 button is illuminated. I see. The FM channel is now set as FM preset 1. Press the FM button or wait 10 seconds to exit the FM setup. The audio level output of the Snap can be increased or decreased as necessary to match the audio levels of other sources in your vehicle. Refer to set audio level on page 32 of the user guide. If the signal reception is good, but there is no audio when tuned to channel 247, verify that both the Snap and your vehicle's FM radio are tuned to the same FM channel. Steps 2 and 3. Also ensure the chosen FM channel is a suitable one to use in your area. Step 1. Also be sure that the audio level is set high enough to be heard. Step 5. Refer to troubleshooting on open bracket AGE36, I assume the main page, of the user guide for additional help. Subscribe! The Snap works on the XM network and requires an XM subscription, not an, no. Before you can start listening, please do the following. Make sure your Snap's turned on receiving the XM signal so that you can hear the XM audio. Make a note of your radio ID. You can find it by pressing menu on a label on the bottom of the gift box, which we saw, and on the label on the back of your Snap. To subscribe online, go to Sirius XM, or by phone, blah, blah, blah. I'll read it. By phone, call 1-877-GET-XMSR, 1-877-438-9677, online, go to www.siriusxm.ca. Activation usually takes 10 to 15 minutes, but may take up to an hour. We recommend that your radio remain on until subscribed. Oh geez, that'll drain your battery, huh? Better be going on a long trip. Once your radio is subscribed, any messages related to the courtesy period will not appear on the display. Okay, we saw all of this, yeah. Snap functions and main display. Snap functions. Number buttons. Press to select your favorite channels. Press and hold to set a favorite channel. Also press to select an FM channel preset. Press and hold to set an FM channel preset. Okay, control knob. Rotate to tune to the previous or next channel within the current category. Also rotate to tune FM channels. Okay. Scan button. Press to start or stop a scan of each channel with the current category. The main display, when listening to a channel, information about what is currently playing is displayed. The screen will alternate between the artist name and song title and the current category name and channel name. Top view. Power button. Press to turn radio off and on. Menu button. Press to access radio ID and adjust audio levels. FM button. Press to access FM channel configuration and FM channel presets. Previous next category buttons. Press to access the previous or next category. Press and hold to cycle through the categories. Antenna signal strength, artist name, or talk show host or sports team score, song title or talk show schedule or game time, game details, category, pop, channel name, 60s on 6, channel number 6. Okay. What's in the box? Snap radio, magnetic mount antenna, auxiliary in cable, cable routing adapter, and alcohol antenna alcohol preparation pad. Okay. Self-installation instructions and tips are provided for your convenience. It is your responsibility to determine if you have the knowledge, skills, and physical ability required to properly perform an installation. Sirius XM shall have no liability for damage or injury resulting from the installation or use of any Sirius XM or third-party products. It is your responsibility to ensure that all products are installed in adherence with local laws and regulations, and in such a manner as to allow a vehicle to be operated safely and without distraction. Sirius XM warranties do not cover the installation, removal, or reinstallation of any product. SiriusXM.ca, address, phone number, blah blah blah. Caution, do not attempt to install, activate, or adjust any of the setting options described in Quick Start Guide unless your vehicle is parked in a safe location. Good plan. Sorry about that. That was long, but figured it shouldn't be too long. Turns out it was long. So here's the French version. I'm not even going to bother. For XM products, if you experience problems with the operation or performance of your product, do not return this product to your retailer. Call XM customer care and speak to one of our service representatives. See inside for warranty details. 90 days warranty. Okay. 90 days. What do we got in here? Here we go. Here is the good stuff. Yes? Let's find out. Got a plastic shell here. The plastic shell is actually thick and of good quality, which doesn't match what the box is. There is bubbles in the protection, the scratch protection of my screen. Here is the antenna. It's actually very small. I expected it to be rather large. There we go. That's nice. The alcohol prep pads in here. This is the cable to attach the antenna. Yep. Here is the... What standard does it use? Oh, all it uses is your standard 3.5 millimeter, 1/8 inch stereo audio male-to-male cable. Okay, good, good. And it would seem that that's all that remains in here, aside from the unit. Yeah, empty box. Okay. And the unit itself. Let's take a look at the unit. I'm going to fix this guy in here. Back again. Camera, you could get in. Alright, good, good. How do we take this guy out? There we go. I don't know if this number is important. Yeah, okay, I'm not going to show you that number, just in case. Here is the unit itself. The knob clicks. It's clickable. buttons, okay, the menu and FM deals on the adapter itself. Antenna goes there, audio goes out there, FM, they didn't even talk about FM. I don't know how FM works, aside from FM modulation, of course. XM, it just reads XM there, not Sirius. Does it have battery? I doubt it. Even if it did, it wouldn't be charged. Anyway, so there you go. That is the Sirius XM Snap. My unboxing up. Gonna give it a try, see how it works. How did this go? Went like this, yeah. Anywho, so there you go. I hope this information was of interest, and as usual, all the best.